start. The first thing to note about this resolution is that it does not merely repeat what we have said before. It points out that the time has come for us to advance on the economic and social plane. In a sense, we have been doing it, but we have not been doing it adequately. The time has come to put an end to unemployment in 10 years. By 10 years, we mean 2 5-year plan periods. I wish you to appreciate that we try not to word our resolution in what might be called bombastic language. We are an old and mature organization with a great deal of experience. It is not desirable, therefore, that we should use words which are vague and meaningless. On the whole, we understate what we propose to do. If we really give effect to this resolution, it means bringing about a revolution in this country, an economic revolution bigger than any that has taken place in our times. Take the simple fact of putting an end to unemployment within 10 years. Just try to think what it means in this country, with its population growing year by year. It is a terrific job, the like of which has not been done in these circumstances in any other country. We talk about planning. As you all know, planning is essential, and without it, there would be anarchy in our economic development. About 5 years ago, planning was not acceptable to many people in high places, but today it has come to be recognized as essential even by the man in the street. Our first 5-year plan is now about 3 years old, and we are now thinking about our second 5-year plan. A phrase in this resolution says that the second 5-year plan must keep the national aims of a welfare state and a socialistic economy before it. These can only be achieved by a considerable increase in national income, and our economic policy must therefore aim at plenty and equitable distribution. The second 5-year plan must keep these objectives in view and should be based on the physical needs of the people. These are really the important and governing words of the resolution and ought to be the controlling factors in drawing up the second 5-year plan. Before going on to other aspects of the question, may I say that a welfare state and a socialistic pattern of economy are not synonymous expressions. It is true that a socialistic economy must provide for a welfare state, but it does not necessarily follow that a welfare state must also be based on a socialistic pattern.